Today, the main way to learn your position on the Earth is to use a smartphone, a handheld GPS unit, or GNSS receiver. All these consumer gadgets have a GPS or GNSS chip inside. To find your location, the receiver uses information from satellites that are constantly moving around the Earth. In this video, we will show you how information from satellites is used to determine your location at a particular time. There are many satellites in the sky above, and each of them has its own orbit. Each satellite also knows its precise position at each moment of time. The satellites are constantly transmitting these two types of data to your GNSS receiver. These signals can be used by GNSS receivers to find your position on the Earth's surface. Let's learn how the GNSS receiver uses both types of data to determine its location. When your device receives a signal from a satellite, it knows when this signal was sent and the position of the satellite in space at that time. The GNSS unit also has its own internal clock, which measures the time when the signal was received. Assuming that there are no GNSS errors, the device can use this information to determine how long it took the signal to reach the receiver. In order to estimate the distance between the satellite and the receiver, this elapsed time is multiplied by the speed of the signal. Keep in mind that the speed of the signal equals the speed of light. Now, the position of the receiver is somewhere on the sphere whose radius equals the calculated distance. However, since the surface of the sphere is a large area, it does not provide your exact location. So, the information from only one satellite is not enough. In order to narrow down the area, we need one more signal from a second satellite. Just like in the first case, the second signal forms another sphere whose radius equals the distance from the second satellite to the receiver. As you see, we now have two spheres that intersect, creating a space in the cross zone. By using the signals from these satellites, the receiver narrows its possible position to the region of the intersection, but it's still not enough to identify the location of the receiver. To solve this, we can add a third satellite to the system. When we have three signals from these satellites, there are only two places where all three spheres intersect at the same moment. The receiver's position, therefore, is in one of these two places. Typically, we can exclude one of the points since it is either deep below the Earth's surface or in an open space. The point left is our position. Now, the three signals should be theoretically enough to find the location of the receiver, but in practice, a signal from a fourth satellite is required. As was mentioned before, the GNSS receiver has its own clock to track the time when a signal is received. Clocks in these receivers use quartz crystals, which do not allow as accurate time estimation as the atomic clocks used in satellites. This accuracy difference causes a variation between the real and the estimated time when a signal arrives at a receiver. This time difference leads to an error in the calculated distance. Therefore, to minimize this error, we need a signal from the fourth satellite. Generally, the more signals from various satellites are used in distance estimation, the more accurately your GNSS unit can determine your location. Traditional GNSS receivers, such as the ones used in smartphones, can only determine the position with several meters of accuracy. Fortunately, with a technique, such as RTK, we can go down to centimeter-level positioning accuracy using GNSS. Learn more about RTK in our next video or in Emlid docs. Thanks for watching.